What you doing, Lucy?
I don't know what they're doing.
The puppies are starting to wonder where we're going. Been on the road forever. City driving too. We just sat through an entire green light. This may not have been my best idea ever. It's a long drive. I don't know if it's gonna be worth it. Look, it's downtown Phoenix. We're not going there, I promise. I think we're getting close to where we are going, though. Hey, what's up? Oh, sorry, that's an airplane. We are at the Rio Salado Habitat Restoration Area near downtown Phoenix. This is along the Salt River, or the Rio Salado. I've been here once before, years ago, without the puppies. But I thought, for something different, we'd come and check this out. It is a habitat restoration area, so we can't go on all the trails. We can only go on the paved trails. But we can go for miles along the river. So we're gonna check that out, see where we can go and what we can do. We had a heck of a time getting here, so let me tell you, it better be worth it. Come on, puppies. They're going crazy so far. It's a new place, so of course they are. Drove across the city, across Chandler, across Phoenix. I think we were in Tempe for part of it too. And then we drove up Baseline, which I absolutely hate. Probably should have come a little bit different way. We used to live way out the other end of Baseline in Levine, and drove Baseline every day for like 8 years, and it sucked every time. We hated it for at least the last 4 of those years, probably more, and it still sucks. So we'll probably take a slightly different route home. I'm gonna get up here along the trail a little bit with the puppies, get them settled in, and then I'll talk to you again. I think that's where they keep all the crocodiles. Don't go in there. It's on this side. Any more crocodiles? Maybe. Found this little trail here. Nothing here is marked. Nothing here is marked as to what you can and can't go down with your dogs. I did see something online, but I don't know if it was true or not. And there's nothing out here. So I'm gonna take my puppers with me. They're not gonna do any damage that I wouldn't do just walking along here. We're in the riverbed. There is no river. Not since they dammed it up. So we're just gonna walk along here for a little bit, see what we see. Right, kids? Sure, step over Lucy while she's peeing. Oh, and the whole reason we're down here along the riverbed is I saw a sign that said waterfall. So I followed it. There is no water, let alone a waterfall. So that sign is a big fat liar. Maybe we should go back the other way. What do you think? How about we walk up here to the bridge and then we'll turn around and go the other way? It's probably like half a mile or so. We'll do that. Lots of noise from airplanes because we're near the airport. Right in the flight path. You know what? We're not going all the way down this trail to that overpass because, or bridge, whatever you want to call it. There's just too much garbage down here. There's like broken glass, there's bottles, there's cans, there's sharp metal objects. It's not worth it. We'll go back up this way and take the higher trail that's paved. Hopefully that is cleaner. And that way I won't have to worry about the puppy stepping on anything. It's kind of disappointing. This place looked a whole lot nicer when I was here a few years ago. It really looks like they've neglected it. Like they sort of gave up on the rehabilitation. Because they really haven't been doing much, I'll tell you that. Okay, here's my opinion of this Rio Salado habitat restoration area. They're not restoring much. If anything, I'd say from the last time I was here, they've torn down a lot of stuff, torn out a lot of trees and natural habitat. They've got an area over here which they're calling their demonstration wetland, which looks like there has been some activity over there. But in order to make their demonstration wetland, they tore out a whole bunch of natural forest area, which makes no sense to me. And there's no real wetland over there. And there's a lot of garbage everywhere. Not a lot of maintenance going on around here. And there's homeless people living out here. We went down that trail where it said waterfall, and then we're gonna go along the river there. And it was just too dirty, too much garbage. But then when we went to go down another trail, there's like homeless people living out here. Down in some of the like less major trails, and that's kind of creepy. Like, I mean, I know homeless people need a safe place to live and everything, but should they really be living out here? I don't think so. And I got some looks that I didn't like, so we're gonna go off the other direction. See if there's anything to look at over here. Give them a bit of a walk. I'm sure they'll enjoy it no matter what. It's just my enjoyment level isn't sky high right now. But that's okay. As long as they enjoy themselves and have some fun, that's all that matters. So we'll do this for a little bit, and then we'll head home to Vinesa. I think she's having a nap right now. And Vinesa and I were planning on going out for dinner tonight, which will be nice. I found the water, and there are some ducks, so I guess it qualifies as a wetland. Doesn't look the nicest though. You can see that they've cut down all kinds of trees so you can look at the wetlands. It's very disappointing. Check this out. Ugh. So they've cut back all of these trees on this side, so you can see down to the water. They've even cut trees down. They've cut this big tree down. They've cut trees down on the other side. Cleared everything out, so you can see their demonstration wetland. Makes me sad. Okay, I have come across some signs now that say no dogs. Like this trail over here has a sign with a dog and a cross through it. So, no dogs, but I'm sure there's people down there with dogs. We won't do it though. We will behave ourselves. I'm all for habitat restoration, if you're gonna actually do it. But it's disappointing that there's even a need for that here. Considering if they didn't dam up the river to create Tempe Town Lake, this would actually be a river. I'm thinking. Maybe there's another dam further up too that prevents this from being a river. Yep, there's people with dogs down there. Here's something interesting. We just passed some people with a pug. And normally, Lucy wants to go meet every dog she sees. The pug sort of gave her the eye, and she ran away. Lucy didn't want to go anywhere near that pug. And then they started following behind us, and Lucy and Willow kept looking behind and kept wanting to go faster. Pugs freak Lucy out apparently, and in turn Willow, because she took the cue from Lucy and they both wanted nothing to do with the pug. This isn't a waterfall. It's a cool bridge though. I like this bridge. Old and rusty, well, new and rusty. And then this down here, I don't know if this is what they're saying is the waterfall. Maybe if it had more water running through it, you could consider this a waterfall. Possibly. Yeah, I would much rather walk around down there with the puppers, because that'd be a much more enjoyable walk than up here on the paved path. There is even a trail down there. Down that way. Sorry, hit the stop button. See, there's a trail down there. I've actually been down there before. It'd be nice if we could walk all the way around through there with the puppies. They don't want dogs down there, because apparently they think dogs are evil and they will kill the habitat if they're down there. I don't think that's true. I think they would just add to it. Okay, look what happened here. I have the puppies over here, and one went behind me, and then they tangled themselves up over here. So my arm is stuck over here, and they're tangled up here, and I don't know what to do now. I can't walk. My legs are tied up. What did they do? No, hold on. Let me get out of this. All right, this is just to give you an idea of where I am in Phoenix right now. In case you live here and you've never been here, or in case you visit and you want to come here, I would say, like, if you just want to come and walk along the trail here, fine. But if you want to go down into the restoration area and stuff, don't bring your dog. And also watch out for all the garbage and homeless people. But this is central. I said we were close to downtown. That's downtown just there, a couple, two or three blocks away. And if I zoom in right here, straight ahead, straight ahead over that post right there, that's Chase Field, the baseball park where the Diamondbacks play. That's right there. And then all the buildings of downtown. And let me zoom back out. And then if you walk this trail, we're at Central now. You can walk all the way to 19th Avenue along this trail along the riverbed. And that's another 1.8 miles, I believe. 1.6, somewhere around there. So you can do 7th, and then it's on the sign over here. Let's go look. This sign right here. 7th Avenue is 0.4 miles, 12th Avenue overlook 0.8 miles, and 19th Avenue 1.6 miles. So if you want to come out here for a walk, might be an idea. There are some views. There's the mountains off that way. It's a lot of mountains. South Mountain. I forget what mountains those are over there. Alright. That was a little freaky. Made it as far as 7th Avenue. There's a trail to go down to what appears to be a large body of water down there. But we got to that overpass there and I heard a noise and I looked around and leave it. And there's a guy sitting up underneath the overpass that started talking to me. Freaked me out. And he just kept talking. Asking what I was doing today, where I was going. I don't think he knows, needs to know that. We gotta go back that way. Being. I guess today must be a nice day. Because no matter how far we walk, these two here want to keep walking further. I wanted to stop here turn around, go back the other way. But these two want nothing of such a thing. They just want to keep going. I don't know if we'll go all the way to 12th Avenue, but we might. Another 0.4 miles. We're probably at the 0.3 mile mark right now. But hey, why not? We came across what I thought looked like crude grave markers, but I found a sign and it says they are downtown owls, borough clusters RS 3 and 4. So check this out. They're like artificial burrows for burrowing owls. That's kind of interesting. Cool. Who'd have thunk? I like that a lot better than graves. Let's get a close up with the sign. You can pause that and read it if you want. Maybe I'll pause it and read it too. Puppers are getting tired and thirsty. I think they would keep walking forever if they could, but I'm going to be the smart one and stop us. Looks like there's a little pedestrian bridge up here. We'll go as far as the bridge. We'll see if there's a fountain up here. If not, we'll go back to the fountain back there and get them a little drink. I think this is 12th Avenue up here, which doesn't actually cross the river. It just sort of ends on each side, but it is 12th Avenue, I believe. So once we get this bridge up here, we'll turn it around right there. You can see it. I know you can. Yippee! Interesting little bridge here. Looks like there's some quarries over here. Riverbed over that way. I think that's what they call the 12th Avenue Outlook over there. So we'll go check that out real quick. So this is the upper trail that we've been walking along, the paved one, and then there is one down here that isn't really maintained, that goes along the riverbed there, along the area that still has some water in it. They call that the terrace trail, I believe. And it looks like there was a bridge over there and it's all washed out. It looks like the water decided to go a different way instead of under the bridge. Washed out the trail. So I guess they're gonna have to fix that. Might be a good idea. Or they could just leave it. Looks like what they do out here is leave a lot of stuff. There's a lot of garbage out here. But you know what? I'm gonna call this a success. We had a good time. Like after the initial like shock of garbage everywhere and the homeless people living down at the main area, it's been not too bad at all. Like, it's a great day for a walk. Easy walk, that's for sure. Be nice if we could go down, like down towards the riverbed where the water is and see some of the wildlife, but they don't want dogs down there. So we'll stick by that, we'll abide by that. We're gonna head back. We just thought we'd take a break in the shade here right now for a second. I was gonna say something else. No, I'd definitely say it's worth coming down here for a walk if you want something like that, or especially if you live over in this area. I'd say go to South Mountain first if you've never been to South Mountain, because that's just over that way a little bit. But if you want something a little different, see a little bit of wildlife, and if you don't bring your dog, you can walk down along the river. Definitely worth it. I've accidentally created a puppy train. I didn't mean for that to happen. Let's go, puppers. I don't think it's working well. All right, so far this walk back isn't working out the greatest. There was my accidental puppy train incident. And there's the fact that they keep wanting to turn around and go back the other way. I told them we're going home. I told them we're going back to the car. I told them we're going to see Vanessa. But for some reason, they keep wanting to go back the other way. Maybe it's a homing instinct from when they were puppies and we used to live out that way. Who knows? More burrow clusters. All kinds of them along here. Glad I read the sign, or I would have thought it was a cemetery along here. Alright, I'm gonna concentrate on getting these puppers back to the car so I can get them a drink. Totally forgot to bring them water out here. I didn't think we'd go this far. My bad. I will make sure I bring them water next time. Sorry, puppers. Well, the puppers and I made it home, and they came right in the door and jumped on Vanessa's face while she was sleeping on the couch. Woke her up. But everything's okay. Puppers are tired, though. They don't even want any food. They don't want lunch. They're just too tired to eat. They got a big drink, though. I got a bowl of cereal, of all things. Now I'm going to sit and drink a big glass of water and have some Dosey-dos. That's what I bought the other day with Vanessa, and she got those lemon ones. I don't remember the names. So I'm going to sit for a bit, and then probably not going to do anything until we go out for dinner. I think that's the plan. So the plan is to have no plan until we go. So I guess that's a plan. Vanessa got dressed up fancy.
She dressed up fancy.
So I dressed up fancy too. Look, there's a collar on my shirt. And we're going out to try a new sushi place. We haven't had sushi since we went to Sushi Eye right before it closed.
In October.
Oh wow, that long ago.
Yeah.
And we've been wanting to go out. And there's another place that gets good reviews and is very popular that we were gonna go try out, but you need a reservation pretty much, and they didn't have anything left for tonight. So we picked the next best thing on the list on Yelp. We're gonna go try it out. Yanagi Sushi over here in Gilbert. So I'll let you know how it turns out. See, look, fancy. High heels too. All right, dinner is done. And what's the verdict, Vanessa?
It was pretty good.
It was pretty good. I don't know that it'll be our go-to place. It's pretty good. Like, I'd come here again. But I still think it's worth checking a couple other places. There were a bunch on Yelp that were, like, tied with the star rating and the amount of ratings they had. So, or reviews. So we might try a couple others until we arrive at the one that we like the most and we'll go to most often. But for now, I think we're going to go home and park our butts in front of the television and watch a movie. I don't know what movie. What movie?
I don't know.
She doesn't know. Okay. That's that then. Well, we are happily home with the puppers. Including this one right here, who is giving my a snuggle and doesn't want me to stop. Oh, Christmas tree's still up. I said we were going to take it down this week, so today's the last day of the week. Don't think it's happening. But I did watch a YouTube video today with somebody who still had their Christmas tree up, so I don't feel too bad. Actually, we ordered some storage containers, and we're getting a storage unit because we don't really have a lot of room in this house to store big things. So as of February 1st, I think we get our storage unit, and then we're getting some big storage containers delivered. I don't know when, sometime in February, beginning of February. So we'll be able to put all of our Christmas stuff away and our Christmas trees in the storage unit and all that stuff. So we are home with the puppies. This puppy and this puppy. And we are going to watch some TV now and relax. So I will see you tomorrow. I think we might go do something tomorrow as a whole family. Willow and Lucy and Vanessa and I. We talked about maybe Saguaro Lake or somewhere else. Don't know for sure. And it all depends on whether I sleep in or not. I didn't today too much. So see what happens. See you then. Peace, love, and... Oh, the puppy's so sweet.